Well, each year, about 14 million metric tons of wheat destined for export move through the Columbia and Snake River system. Now, to highlight the importance of this and the consequences of breaching the four lower Snake River dams would have on the agriculture community, a tour was held this past week to provide attendees a firsthand experience of this essential transportation system.
We were very fortunate to be invited out by the Idaho Grain Producers Association and Idaho Farm Bureau to look at the importance of the navigation system of the Columbia Snake River and the efficiencies that it brings to the commodity markets, especially for wheat, and especially during a time of everything is all about sustainability, looking at how efficient barges are compared to additional rail or trucks being put on the highway. So it was a very educational tour.
Andy says exports are critical to U.S. wheat growers, and maintaining these locks and dams plays a vital role in ensuring our competitiveness, providing a safe and reliable mode of transportation, and are essential to the long-term viability of our industry throughout the entire region.
These dams provide such a benefit and economic stimulus to this area that breaching those dams is going to be devastating, not only to the fish population, but to rural America and the agriculture communities in that area, all the way to the West Coast that pin on the Columbia and River and the Snake River system.
Now, over 60% of the cargo that moves on the Columbia Snake River system is high-quality U.S. wheat grown right here in our region and exported overseas. In fact, nearly 10% of all U.S. wheat exports actually travel by barge on the Snake River each year. In Billings, Russell Nemitz, MTN News.